So I'm going to talk a little bit today about the role of telemedicine in pediatric concussion care. I have a couple disclosures that were mentioned. So pediatric sport-related concussion is a condition that affects thousands of Canadian children annually, as we all know. With timely access to proper medical assessment and management, most patients will experience a complete recovery and make a successful return to school and sport-related activities within about 4 weeks. But those that don't receive timely care are at risk of premature return to activities that can result in repeat injuries associated with persistent symptoms and more severe forms of traumatic brain injury. Unfortunately, there's evidence that access to high-quality concussion care is not universally available to all Canadians. We know that research has shown that only one-third of youth receive proper medical follow-up and clearance after their injuries. There's been significant concussion knowledge gaps that have been documented among Canadian primary care providers. 60% of Canadian concussion clinics do not seem to have on-site access to physicians, and few have access to the full team of professionals that would be needed to address the complex needs of concussion patients. In Manitoba, we're lucky. We work in a province that has a provincial government-funded pediatric concussion program that does have access to a complete multidisciplinary team that cares for patients that have sport and non-sport related injuries and serves a catchment area that includes Manitoba, Northwestern Ontario, and Central Nunavut. Using the Canadian Guideline on Concussion in Sport and in partnership with Sport Manitoba and our provincial government, we've been able to develop web pages, harmonize sport and school-specific protocols, and develop concussion seminars using the CERC and Parachute resources. Although access to high-quality primary and specialized concussion care is a concern for youth throughout Canada, it's even more limited for patients and children that live in rural, remote, and isolated communities. Within our catchment area here in Manitoba, we serve communities that are a fair distance away by road, and we also serve communities that for which there is no road access. So for the last 3 years or so, we've been trying to build a telemedicine program to provide better and more equitable care. Telemedicine has been translated as healing at a distance, and it can include synchronous forms such as in-person video conferencing and asynchronous forms such as e-consultation. We started this project by starting a pilot project in Thompson, Manitoba, in the Thompson General Hospital, which is about 760 kilometers away. During this pilot project, 20 patients were evaluated. The injury mechanisms included sport and non-sport related activities. 90% of the patients underwent initial assessment through in-person video conferencing, and the diagnosis include 14 acute concussion, one persistent post-concussion symptoms, and two infants with head injuries. A small proportion of these patients were required to see other members of our multidisciplinary team in Winnipeg and other areas, and one patient had to undergo an MRI. In terms of the outcomes, 90% of the patients met the clinical criteria for recovery, one remained in treatment at the end of the study period, and one was discharged to the care of a headache neurologist, and the median time of clinical recovery was 25 days. Importantly, 80% of the patients that were evaluated through this study were managed exclusively through telemedicine, so they never needed to leave their community to receive care, and this translated into significant estimated cost avoidance for the project. And this doesn't take into account travel from flying communities that are only accessible by plane, accommodations, food, and expenses related to escorts. So what we've learned from this experience is that telemedicine can enhance access to specialized care. It can provide greater continuity of care, less time away from people's families, decrease travel time, and reduce costs. But there are some challenges and limitations, such as the inability to perform a complete physical examination. It does require access to high quality, secure in-person video conferencing. There are some licensing issues for those providing care. There are some startup and maintenance costs related to the technology. And at the time of the project, we lacked culturally appropriate educational resources. The last limitation we've now addressed by partnering with Parachute and our Indigenous partners to develop post-injury education sheets that have now been adapted for First Nations and Nunavut youth. We then, after this pilot project, then partnered with our other Indigenous leaders, or our leaders in Indigenous health, to develop what is now a highly integrated pediatric telemedicine program. So now we routinely care for children with concussions all throughout Manitoba and the Kivalliq region of Nunavut, many of whom don't need to leave their communities to receive care. And when they do, we bring them down to Winnipeg and coordinate all of those consultations so that they can be occur in a coordinated manner and limit the amount of trips for patients and their families. Using this experience, we've now refined our approach such that we've now developed evidence-informed clinical algorithms, remote physical examination tools, and we've also developed some tools for the initial medical and follow-up assessment. And so we're becoming better at knowing which patients we can see virtually and which patients we need to arrange an in-person assessment for. We do think that in the future, we'll be able to use remote presence robots to enhance this approach, especially as they provide a lot better agility when it comes to doing some of the physical examination. And we're hoping to pilot this in some northern communities in the near future. So concussion's a condition that affects thousands of Canadian youth annually. Youth living in some rural and remote northern communities in Canada have limited access to primary and specialized concussion care. And with appropriate expertise, telemedicine can be a helpful tool to deliver national best practice care to athletes and patients across Canada and beyond.